How's it going, everybody? Chip Bleem here from Freedom Chiropractic and Rehab. Today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about osteoporosis, osteopenia, and the impact that exercise has on it. So earlier this week I got a question from a patient of ours. She had recently been diagnosed with osteopenia, which is just the beginnings of some demineralization. It hasn't quite reached the point of osteoporosis, right? Osteoporosis is the loss of calcium within the bone, which makes the bone a little bit more fragile, okay? So osteopenia would be the precursor to osteoporosis. And as we get older, once we reach a certain point, typically it's around like age 35 or so, we begin to lose bone density. So you can build bone density up until about age 35, then it's just a matter of how much can we slow the process down, okay? So what's one of the best ways to treat that osteopenia or osteoporosis? It's exercise, right? But there's different types of exercise and some are better than others, okay? So this patient had brought in an article that she got from WebMD, which is a great resource. However, you have to be careful because sometimes, you know, they catastrophize a lot of things. But what this article talked about was doing high intensity exercise, which I thought was great. And then I read the article. So the article suggested that walking and using an elliptical machine and those kinds of things were considered, you know, a higher intensity exercise. And in my opinion, those are not sufficient to treat this injury, right? Or this disease process. What we have to do is to work towards resistance training, right? So I want you to pick up weight, right? Not just body weight. So let's look at the hierarchy of what's good versus what's bad. Swimming would be the lowest end because there's non-weight bearing exercise, right? You're not actually going to be getting stronger while you swim. Walking on a treadmill or walking on an elliptical, at least you're standing upright, so you're getting the impact of gravity. The next thing would be to do body weight movements like air squats or those kinds of things. So squats with no weight would give you some benefit. But the most beneficial is going to be squats with resistance. And the more resistance that you can do, the better off you're going to be. Now, I wouldn't necessarily recommend that you do these really, really fast. A slow, controlled movement, whether it's a squat or a deadlift or something along those lines, will give you a lot more benefit with a lot lower risk for injury, okay? So these are some ideas as to what we can do in terms of treating osteopenia and osteoporosis from a non-pharmacological side, right? So not using medication. So if you've been diagnosed with osteopenia or osteoporosis, find a professional who can help you to treat it as much as possible using exercise. Okay? Exercise is one of the best medications we have, and unfortunately it's underprescribed and underutilized in our country. Let us help you. So if you have questions, feel free to reach out to us. If there's things you want to hear me talk about in this little segment, feel free to hit me up with those too. Leave a comment, like, share, subscribe, all those things. Let us know if we can help. All right? Thank you very much. I appreciate you watching this video, and we'll catch up with you soon.